Learning is any relatively permanent change in behavior that occurs as a result of experience. Robbins. Today, let us learn one such type of learning named classical conditioning. This type of learning was first investigated by Ivan B. Pavlov, a Russian physiologist. He was primarily interested in the physiology of digestion. During his studies, he noticed that dogs on whom he was doing his experiments started secreting saliva as soon as they saw the empty plate in which food was served. So Pavlov designed an experiment to understand this process in detail, in which dogs were used once again. In the first phase, a dog was placed in a box and harnessed. The dog was left in the box for some time. This was repeated a number of times on different days. In the meantime, a simple surgery was conducted and one end of a tube was inserted in the dog's jaw and the other end of the tube was put in a measuring glass. In the second phase of the experiment, the dog was kept hungry and placed in harness with one end of the tube ending in the jaw and the other end in the glass jar. A bell was sounded and immediately thereafter food, that is meat powder, was served to the dog. The dog was allowed to eat it. For the next few days, every time the meat powder was presented, it was preceded by the sound of a bell. After a number of such trials, a test trial was introduced in which everything was the same as the previous trials, except that no food followed the sounding of the bell. The dog still salivated to the sound of the bell, expecting presentation of the meat powder, as the sound of the bell had come to be connected with it. This association between the bell and food resulted in acquisition of a new response by the dog, that is, salivation to the sound of the bell. Food is the unconditioned stimulus, and salivation which follows it is an unconditioned response. After conditioning, salivation started to occur in the presence of the sound of the bell. Therefore, the bell becomes a conditioned stimulus and saliva secretion a conditioned response. This kind of conditioning is called classical conditioning. It is obvious that the learning situation in classical conditioning is one of the SS learning, in which one stimulus, example the sound of the bell, becomes a signal for another stimulus, that is food. So it is a stimulus signal learning. Classical conditioning is also referred to as Pavlovian conditioning. Another name for it is respondent conditioning. Let's have a look at the different terms used here. Unconditioned stimulus, it means it is the stimulus that is innately capable of eliciting a response. So here, the food is the unconditioned stimulus. Unconditioned response, it is innate or unlearned reflex elicited by an unconditioned stimulus. So in Pavlov's experiment, salivation was the unconditioned response. The dog salivated reflexively and spontaneously to the meat powder. Conditioned stimulus. Now this is a previously neutral stimulus that acquires the capacity to evoke a response by being paired with an unconditioned stimulus. In Pavlov's experiment, the bell was initially a neutral stimulus, but because of pairing it with food, that is, the unconditioned stimulus acquired the capacity to elicit salivation. And lastly is the conditioned response. Now, this is a learned response to the conditioned stimulus. So, in Pavlov's experiment, the dog's salivation to the bell alone is the conditioned response. Let us now look at the examples of classical conditioning in our daily life. Have you ever been in a public area and heard the same notification tone as yours? Did you instinctively reach for your phone? Well, that is classical conditioning in action. Actually, the smartphone we carry is associated with ways to meet our psychological needs for autonomy, competence, and relatedness. It gives us access to endless content in the form of news, entertainment, and knowledge, as well as connects us with other people. Since these things have been paired on a regular basis, the rings and buzzes of our phones trigger automatic reflexive responses. Another example could be Christmas music. The taste of peppermint, the look of lights strung on houses, the decorated Christmas trees, the smell of Christmas cookies, and the sound of Christmas music. These are the things people associate with end of the year holidays, isn't it? So when you listen to popular Christmas songs, your mind starts recalling those happy memories associated with holidays. Thank you for watching the lecture. I hereby conclude my presentation.